Now, where did I put it? Aha! There it is. Ah, so today I'm standing here in Castle's Museum, which is actually really interesting. You guys can check it out. Today we're going to be looking at Castle Milano. Let's get it on.
Being the oldest malting plant in Belgium means we make a lot of different kinds of malt, which is fantastic for making award-winning beers. However, sometimes brewers still have a hard time understanding how they are to be used. Don't worry, we've got you covered. In this series, we show you how to use each and every single one of all of our malts.
So Castle Melano is a very interesting malt. The word Melano comes from the word Melanoidin. Now Melanoidin are the compounds you get when you are slowly increasing the temperature of the malt and drying it at the same time. So it's a very sort of a rich Maillard flavor profile that you get specifically from malt and, you know, similar types of cereals. And there is a lot of different ways that you can actually use this to pump up the flavor of your beer. The lab, it's around the corner, so let's drag you guys in and see what the lab guys have to say about this.
Castle Melano Malt is made by putting green malt into the kiln and undergoes a special process at 130 degrees Celsius, specifically increasing the amount of melanoidins produced to the maximum. This has led to this variety of malt being referred to as Turbo Munich.
Alors le malt Melano, on a le Melano 40 et le 80, sont des malts qui ont été développés vraiment pour développer de la couleur dans vos bières. Alors principalement pour aller sur des tons rouges, ambrés, et donc les bières rouges sont généralement fabriquées avec ce type de malt.
Belgian Beers. Bier de Mars. A beautifully brewed Bier de Mars has a bright red color and is full of malt character. Use 5 to 8% Melano malt and remember to ensure that the final gravity is slightly higher to allow a bit of sweetness to remain. Saison. This thirst quenching beer needs to have a dry finish, as is traditional in Belgium, for which this malt is perfect. Adding about 2 to 3% will boost the malt aspect, upon which the yeast can work its magic. British Beers. Scottish Export. A dry malt character is ideal for this style of beer, especially in that it balances out all that caramel that this style is famous for. Use up to 10% for the best results. German Beers. Festbier. A beer that is halfway between a Märzen and a Helles. It should be dry to be drinkable in large quantities. A rich malt note that complements the inevitable addition of Munich malt to the recipe would never go amiss. About 3 to 5% should be just right, keeping an eye on the final color. Vienna Lager. Here all we are trying to do is celebrate the flavor of the Vienna malt by giving it a little boost. 1 to 2% of the grist should be plenty to create a malt backbone you want to smack your lips around. American Beers. Rye IPA. This is a beer that needs to finish dry and have malt characteristics that do not clash with the hops. Use up to 10% in the grist. California Common. Not a typical addition at all to this style of beer, but past experience says it works. Adding about 5% to the rest of the standard malt bill for this style creates an excellent backdrop for the fruity lager yeast and the earthy, herbal hops required for this style.